They didn't have anything. They had a fairly abused dental chair, some really, really rudimentary sterilization equipment. They didn't have an overhead lamp. It was a dental clinic unlike I've ever seen in the United States. Near 1,000 people actually came by, whether they were discouraged by the lines and just chose not to wait. I think the number of people that we actually saw, physically looked at, evaluated, examined, certainly exceeded 650.
I came from the border of Kenya and Uganda. I came alone. It took me 3 hours to get here. My last bus leaves at 5:30. I hope to see the doctor before that.
I took a day off to come here. I also told my daughter not to go to school so that they can come for this dental clinic.
Dr. Frank Kamau, he is a dentist and was practicing there, although the kind of work that he was able to do was limited, not necessarily based on his skill set, but based on just what the people could afford to do.
What we do here mostly, we just do the extractions.
You mostly do extractions?
Yeah, because our unit failed. We tried to repair it due to lack of funds. It's just dead.
I wanted him to have an x-ray taken of the bottom tooth because I think the bottom tooth may be saved. And if we can save teeth, dentists are in the business of saving teeth. We do not like to pull teeth.
Yeah.
We like to save them, okay?
The choice of having a tooth extracted versus having the tooth saved was not altogether given to them.
We are tired of removing ruling teeth. We want to solve our problem by treating them, feeling or planting other new tooth, but it's expensive. They say almost nearly 7,000 for feelings. It's expensive for us.
Most people do not have insurance because of the way the medical setup is in our country. The government has very little resources to have an equivalent of a Medicare. Also, you will have rich people also in Kitale, mostly farmers, who can afford to provide for themselves. But majority of the people really struggle.
If the cost of removing is at least reasonable, it will be better.
I'm a teacher. But I'm supposed to be in class. It is expensive to go to the dentist. That's why I've come here.
I was sending many, many patients out of the clinic to Dr. Kimau's office, forgetting that they didn't have the means to be able to afford his services. There's a huge disparity between both knowledge of the dentist, what the patients understand about dentistry, the resources needed, and the resources available.
Usile ama usiniwe kwa masaa mawili. Sawa?
Our equipment didn't arrive until the third day, which was disappointing, but we were able to do a great, great bit of good just in doing diagnosis and oral hygiene instruction to a lot of folks.
We have noticed that Kenyans put a lot of sugar in their tea. Sugar is very bad for the teeth.
The importance of oral hygiene education to Kenyans, at least in this particular area, cannot be underestimated. I would say that at least 90% of the people did not own toothbrushes or any of the other means that we take for granted. I noticed that soon after our first demonstration and seeing the receptiveness of the people there, I think that kind of enthusiasm was contagious for the Kenyan team who witnessed this and saw with just a little bit of effort what kind of value you can bring to a people. And then it's not about expensive, sophisticated dental equipment being necessary to provide a service. Sometimes it's something as simple as the spoken language. And we did see just how much more willing they were to share information and to educate the people that they were taking care of. Yeah! When the equipment finally arrived, we were able to go from a choice of do we extract the tooth or give them medication to put them in a place of comfort until such time where they could have the tooth restored, to another place, which was, we can fix your tooth for you. I had a constant rotating team of dental assistants, none of whom were trained, but who were willing to get in there and to assist me. On the Kenyan side, we had two students who were training to be dentists in Nairobi, who actually acted as very, very effective dental assistants.
What's he complaining about?
I think there was a lot of exchange of goodwill that the Kenyan team was really, really anxious to learn how an American dental practice was run. They were also interested in the ways of America. And clearly we were interested in the Kenyan ways.
You need a jacket. You know the jacket?
You
it's
mean
an instrument. There's a scanner called jacket. It's thick.
Is it like a hoe?
We couldn't have done it without them, and certainly they couldn't have done it without us.
More than anything, I think it is just the exchange of gifts and talents. People from the United States will be blessed by giving. And also the people in Kitale will feel they have friends who can help at the time of need.
Okay, guess what? You're my last patient in Kenya. You know the expression, last but not least? That's you.
I would like him to come back because there are so many who have not been attended to because of the time was very short. And maybe when he comes back, he can come a bit and stay a little bit longer so that some people can also get that chance of being filled, washed, and x-ray and everything.
You were incredibly generous and hospitable in spirit and in deed, and I really appreciate it. It was really a fun week. Frustrating sometimes, but in the end, good things.
Hold it.
Yeah, exactly. As I read somewhere recently, you know, anything important is not anything to be done that's truly, truly worthwhile. Doesn't take a lifetime. Therefore, the only thing you can do is to increase hope and provide hope.
Sure.
Anything worthwhile.